point, turn for holding break and continue with the solution. Critical problems. All right, let's look at page 209 examples 11 and 12. And it reads here, example 11, the interval of root x plus the cube root of x. Problem number 12, page 209. This one involves some trigonometric expression. Let's find it first. And it said if find the integral log of sine theta minus a half d theta by 2.
Find the integral sine theta.
Minus a half
sine theta minus a half d theta by 2. Alright, if you simplify this again by removing the brackets, and we have now what is the integral of sine theta d theta 1/3 minus a half multiplied by 3 d theta. If you do the integration now, the integral of sine theta, you say dy by dx of cos theta is equal to minus sine theta. If we integrate minus sine theta, you get cos theta. So this is equal to 1/3 cos theta with minus sine minus 1/6 theta.
The integral of 1/3 sine theta d theta, known as the integral of
1/3 1/2 d theta by 3, which is 1/6 d theta.
Well, let's tackle another little problem here. Done this one over and over, but since it's going to take a short time, we'll do this and then we take a short break.
We are taking this short break because of the video clipping. We get the technical problems that we run it over too long. So I'm going to integrate now x over 1 plus x, or rather dx over 1 plus x, make it even simpler.
And this is problem number 17, same page 201.
So dx of 1 plus x, and that's now equal to, you see this takes the form of the integral of 1 over x, which we know to be equal to the logarithm of x. Right? So this is equal to the logarithm of 1 plus x plus some constant. And for this problem, we could always say constant can also be some, say, logarithm. Sometimes we find it easier to write the constant in the form of the same logs, so that we could easily, do some other simplification. But the log itself, see, same constant. All right, for those of you who couldn't spot this right away, you could make a substitution. Okay. I would say this, the integral.
Substitution.
Well, you could get into the habit of making a substitution when it gets more complicated, because then it will easily avoid a relative mistake in the coefficient of these terms here, which will require some arithmetic manipulation. So there it is. So we have done three short problems in this short video clip. And we take a short break.